अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास 9, हाउ आर यू ऑल? ओके, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक ऑफ फिजिक्स, विच इज़ द आर्किमिडीज प्रिंसिपल. सो आर्किमिडीज वॉज द साइंटिस्ट हु डिस्कवर द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड द लिक्विड. हाउ ही डिस्कवर द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड लिक्विड्स. सो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द डिटेल ऑफ दिस टॉपिक. ओके, इन ऑर्डर टू स्टडी द डिटेल ऑफ दिस टॉपिक, वी विल कंसिडर द एग्जाम्पल्स फ्रॉम आवर डेली लाइफ. लेट अस टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द बैलून दैट द चिल्ड्रन प्ले एवरी डे. ओके, सो इफ वी प्लेस द बैलून इन द एम्प्टी बीकर, द बैलून विल गो इन टू द सर्फेस ऑफ द इन टू द सर्फेस ऑफ द बीकर. सो एज वी फिल द बीकर विद द वॉटर, एज वी फिल द बीकर विद द वॉटर, द बैलून विद इन द बीकर विल स्टार्ट टू फ्लोट ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द वॉटर. सिमिलरली, इफ वी प्लेस द पीस ऑफ वुड ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द वॉटर, इट विल ऑल्सो फ्लोट ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द वॉटर. Now the question arises here, why these things float on the surface of the water, the piece of wood and the balloon, why these flow on the surface of the water? Just because the weight of the water and the weight of the water is more than the weight of the balloon and the piece of wood. Okay, so just as the weight of the water and the volume of the water is larger than the piece of wood and the balloon, so these things will start to float on the surface of the water. Why they float on, why these objects float on the surface of the water? There is another reason behind that. An upthrust force will exerted by the liquid on the objects, which causes the lighter objects to flow on the surface of the water. Archimedes was the Greek scientist. About 2000 years ago, he noticed that there is an upward force which act on the object kept inside the liquid. Okay, so as a result, an apparent loss of weight is observed in the object. The upward force will act on the object which is known as the upthrust of the liquid. The upward force which act on the object is known as the upthrust of the liquid. So as we see in case of the balloon, or we see in case of the piece of the wooden block, why they float on the surface of the water? Just because the water will exert, the water will exert the upthrust force on the upthrust force on the on these objects, like the piece of the wooden block and the balloon, which causes them to float on the surface of the water. So let's come towards the definition of the Archimedes principle, which says that when the object is totally or partially immersed in the liquid, an upthrust force act on it equal to the weight of the liquid it displaces. It means that the weight of the object that it displaces the liquid is equal to the upthrust force that act on it. Okay, when the object is totally or partially immersed in the liquid. In order to understand the concept of the Archimedes principle, we performed the simple experiment of the solid cylinder, and we placed the solid cylinder in the beaker which is filled with the water. Okay, we consider a solid cylinder of the cross sectional area A and the height h immersed in the liquid. Now we consider its construction. Let H1 and H2 be the depths of the top and bottom faces of the cylinder, respectively, from the surface of the liquid. ओके, पी वन एंड पी टू आर द लिक्विड प्रेशर्स एट द डेप्थ एच वन एंड एच टू रिस्पेक्टिवली एंड रो बी द डेंसिटी. See that h1 be the height of the top face of the cylinder from the surface of the liquid and h2 be the height of the bottom face of the cylinder from the surface of the liquid. So we subtract these h2 with h1, we get the remaining height. If we subtract h2 with h1, we get the remaining height. So P1 and P2 are the liquid pressures at the depth H1 and H2 respectively, and rho be the density as we have stated in the construction. So according to the equation, the formula of the P1 be the formula of the pressure be rho gh. So we place the formulas in the equation. P1 is equal to rho g h1 and P2 is equal to rho g h2. Now we have considered the heights as well, pressures as well. So let us consider the forces as well. Let the force F1 be exerted at the cylinder top by the liquid due to the pressure P1. Okay, due to the pressure P1, the force F1 is exerted by the liquid at the top face of the cylinder, and F2 be exerted at the bottom of the cylinder by the liquid due to the P2. So as we all know that the pressure is given by the formula, which is force per unit area. Now here we have given two forces F1 and F2, and the two pressures are over there. So and we have to find out the forces F1 and F2. For this purpose, we multiply the pressure with the area, and we get the respective equation. F1 is equal to P1A and F2 is equal to P2A. Now we all know that pressure is equal to rho g h. So putting the values of the pressure in P1 and P2 respectively, we get the equation rho g h1 multiplied by a and rho g h2 multiplied by a. In short, we get the formula F1 is equal to rho g h1 multiplied by a and F2 is equal to rho g h2 multiplied by a. F1 and F2 are acting on the opposite faces of the cylinder. So the net force will be F2 minus F1 in the direction of F2. Net force of the cylinder is called the upthrust of the liquid. So we get the formula F2 minus F1 is equal to rho g H2A minus rho g H1A. Now rho g A are common at both the sides. So we take rho g A common, and in the brackets we put H2 minus H1. So as we all know that H2 minus H1 is equal to the height h. So upthrust of the liquid, the net force upthrust of the liquid, which is F2 minus F1, is equal to rho g A multiplied by height h. Now area multiplied by height is equal to volume. As we all know, area multiplied by height is equal to volume. So we get the final equation, which is rho g v. Okay, rho g and v. Here v is the volume of the cylinder and is equal to the volume of the liquid displaced by the cylinder, and rho g v, g is the gravity, v is the volume, and rho is the density. So rho g v is the weight of the liquid the cylinder displaces. So the upthrust force, hence we conclude that the upthrust force act on the body immersed in a liquid is equal to the weight of the liquid the cylinder displaces, which is the Archimedes principle.